By now, you probably understand this base 10 place value stuff forward and backward. Not to bore you to infinity, I'm going to assume that you understand each column you see is 10 times more than the column to its right. Because our base 10 system is also called a decimal system, there's some more to understand. You know how at the end of a complete sentence is some type of punctuation? Well, at the end of a number, more correctly worded in this case, an integer, is what is called a decimal point. That aside, we are supposed to know it's there. We don't put it there, not unless we need to. Go figure. Anyhow, let's understand what this decimal is all about.
The decimal point separates the ones place from those values less than one, which are called decimal fractions. The point appears just to the right of the ones place itself. The decimal columns also work in groups of 10. The ones place, if not one itself, is central to all notation, not the point. So how do we get the values of the decimal columns? As seen earlier, each column to the left is 10 times more than the column to its right. To find the value of the columns in the opposite direction, mathematically, it would only make sense to use an opposite operation. More correctly worded, an inverse operation. The inverse operation of multiplication is division. How can we be sure of that? Remember how 10 groups of 10 cookies equals 100 cookies? Well, if you had a party with 9 friends, which means 10 people would be at that party, and you had 100 cookies to be divided by 10 people, well, most importantly, we know who's not going to get that cookie. But kidding aside and getting up to speed in algebra, whatever is done to one side of an equation can be done to the other side of the equation, and the equation will still remain equal on both sides. So, if 10 times 10 equals 100, then 100 divided by 10 would equal 10, or in this case, 10 cookies for each. Then 100 divided by 10 would equal 10. Moving along in our base 10 or decimal number system, let's start with the hundreds place. To find out the value of the column to its immediate right, we would divide the hundreds place by 10, leaving us with 10 as the place value for that column, which we already understand to be the tens place. Take notice what's happening to the exponents. Remember multiplying like numbers by like numbers, we added the exponents? In doing the inverse, what I mean is to divide like numbers by like numbers, you would subtract the exponents. Let's follow through to the ones place. It is pretty straightforward as to what is happening. We are just traveling in the opposite direction. So that brings us to where we want to be. To figure out the place value for decimal fractions, using the same pattern, we divide the 1 by 10, which is 1/10. So all the digits in the first column after the point are multiplied by 1/10. This is why we call it the tenths place. Digits here can be referred to as 1/10, 2/10, 3/10, and so on. You can also refer to them as 0.1, 0.2, etc. Moving along, this pattern can be used to infinity, but the values get so small you will probably be told to round off to some place value. As we have been following the pattern, also notice in subtracting the exponents, we end up with negative exponents to represent the values of the decimal columns. A negative exponent represents 1 over the base to that power. In our base 10, it's easy to see how we come up with 1/10. Now, some may know how to divide fractions by fractions, but what is actually happening here? Well, let's say you're going to divide 6 by 3. And if you don't know already, 6 is the dividend and 3 is the divisor. The answer in a division problem is the quotient. Moving along, 6 divided by 3 can be written as 6 over 1 divided by 3 over 1. Now you can see it as a fraction being divided by a fraction. In knowing the outcome, it's easy to see why dividing a fraction by another fraction is simply multiplying the numerator or dividend by the reciprocal of the denominator or divisor. And that brings us to how 1/10 divided by 10 is 1/100. And then we get 1/1000th and so on. Lastly, the language used in mathematics is specific. Be sure to understand what is being asked, read, or what you are saying. Well, we can go on forever, but I think you get the message.